Hello kids, welcome to Learner's Planet. Kids, this is our third session for fractions. In this session, we'll learn about equivalent fractions. Now, what are equivalent fractions? See, we have already discussed how do we make fractions, right? We cut a complete figure into equal parts and one or two or more of equal parts out of the total parts are fractions. Okay, suppose here I can show you this figure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 equal parts are there. Now out of 6 equal parts, 2 of them are pink. So out of 6, 2 are pink. So it is, pink is what fraction of the whole? 2 by 6. Okay, pink is 2 by 6 fraction of whole. Of whole means of 1. Okay, similarly here 1, 2, 3, 3 equal parts and 1 part is pink. So this is 1/3 of the whole. Pink is what portion? 1/3 of the whole. Okay, so in this session we'll learn about equivalent fractions. So let's begin this session. Now, once again you have one full pizza. Okay, one whole pizza I can say. So this is a pizza for you, right? Your mama has made a very tasty pizza for you. Now your friend Amit is coming. Okay, now this, what you have to do, you have to cut the pizza in two equal portions, right? So this portion is of yours and this portion is of Amit. Okay, so this is 1/2 and this is also 1/2. So half, 1/2 means half, half of the pizza you will eat, half of the pizza Amit will eat. Now, when you started eating, you found the pizza pieces so big that you cannot hold it properly. Okay, so this piece is so big that you cannot hold it properly. So you tell your mama, just cut the pizza into further two pieces, right? Just cut the pizza into further two pieces. So your mama, what does she do? She cuts each piece in two more pieces, right? So you got four pieces of the total pizza, of the whole pizza, right? But you have to eat half of the pizza. That means this portion you are eating and this portion your friend is eating. Okay, so what, how many pieces you are eating? Actually you are eating half of the pizza, but how many pieces? 1 and 2. But these two pieces makes half of the pizza, right? And these two pieces also makes half of the pizza, right? So these two pieces, how many pieces are there in all? 1, 2, 3, 4. So these two are 2 out of 4 pieces and these 2 are also 2 out of 4 pieces. But this is what? Half of the pizza, because this and this is same. You just have cut the piece into 2 equal parts. So this and this is same and this is same. That means 2 by 4 and 1 by 2, both of them are same. 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4. So we call them equivalent fractions, right? So if you eat 2 pieces out of 4, that means you are eating 1 piece out of 2. Okay, both of them are same thing. Now, if you further cut this pizza into more pieces, now see what happens. You have cut this pizza into more pieces. So you put a cut over here, over here, over here and over here. Now you can see this portion belongs to you, this portion belongs to Amit and this is you. Now this is half of the pizza, yes, this is half of the pizza. This is same like this and this is also half of the pizza, same like this, right? So you are eating half of the pizza and Amit is eating half of the pizza. So you are eating half of the pizza, right? And now how many pieces are there of this pizza? Start from this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In all there are 8 pieces, and out of 8 pieces you are eating 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces. So what is your portion? 4 out of 8. But actually how much pizza you are eating? Half of the pizza. And out of 8 pieces you are eating 4 pieces. That means half is equal to 4 by 8. Right? That means half is equal to 2 by 4 and that is equal to 4 by 8. Right? So you are eating half of the pizza. That means if there are 4 pieces, you will be eating 2 pieces. If there are 8 pieces, you will be eating 4 pieces. Right? So 4 by 8 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. Okay? In each case, the quantity of pizza which you are eating is same. Right? Quantity or amount of pizza in each case is same. Right? But you have cut the pizza into smaller pieces. That's why number of equal pieces are increasing, but number of your portion is also increasing. If there are 2 portions, then you are eating 1 portion. If there are 4 portions, then you are eating 2 portions. If there are 8 portions, you are eating 4 portions. Okay? Here you can see it once again. There are, your portion is half, right? If half is cut into 2 equal pieces, then 1, 2, 3, 4 out of 4 pieces, your portion is 2 part, right? And if this half is further cut into 2 more pieces, each piece is cut into 2 more pieces, 2 pieces, then in all, out of 8 parts, your portion is 1, 2, 3, 4 parts. Now you can see, this portion is equal to this portion is equal to this portion. That means 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to 4 by 8. Right? 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to 4 by 8. Now how do we get 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to 4 by 8? Suppose you have 1 by 2. Now each piece is cut into 2. Then you have to multiply this number by 2 and this number by 2, right? This piece is cut into 2, so this piece will also cut into 2. So how many pieces you are getting? 2, 1 into 2 is 2 and 2 into 2 is 4, right? Further, if you wish to cut each piece into 2 more pieces, then this piece is cut into 2, this also cut into 2. So 2 and 2 into 2 is 4, 4 into 2 is 8. So 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4 is equal to 4 by 8. We call them equivalent fractions. That means value of these fractions are equal. Okay? If you cut the pieces into more parts, then you'll be getting other equivalent fractions. Okay? Now, you can see a hexagon over here, and this hexagon is divided into two equal parts. So, this is 1 by 2 and this is 1 by 2. 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Similarly, this is 1 by 2, this is 1 by 2. Now, what I do? I cut each part into 3 equal parts. So, what I do? Right? Still, this one is half of the hexagon and this one is half of the hexagon. But in this part, you can see there are 3 parts. 1, 2, 3. Right? 1, 2, 3. So, if the in entire hexagon, there are 6 parts. Okay, and in this portion there are three parts. So out of six, three parts are there in this portion. And actually this portion is identical to this portion. This means half is equal to 3 by 6. Right? This 1, 2, 3 out of total 6. So this portion is 3 by 6. But this portion is half. So half is equal to 3 by 6. Right? Again, one part that was one part. This was one part, right? This is one part. Out of two parts, I divide this part into three equal parts. 1, 2, 3. So I divide one part into three equal parts. So two part will also be divided into three equal parts. So 1 into 3 is equal to 3. 2 into 3 is equal to 6. Okay? If you divide further, then still it is half of the hexagon. Now how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, so this portion is half and this portion is also half. Now how many portions are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And total number of portions? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Right? And this is actually half. And this is 6 out of 12. So, 1 by 2 is 6 by 12. Okay? That means each part, this each part, this is one part, is divided among 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 part. One part is divided into 6 parts. Okay? And so 2 part will also be divided into 6 parts. So 1 into 6 is equal to 6. 2 into 6 is equal to 12. So 1 by 2 is equal to 6 by 12 is equal to 3 by 6. So all of them are equal to each other and we call them equivalent fractions. Okay? Now kids, we discuss more about equivalent fractions. Okay, now suppose on the occasion of Diwali, your papa, your mama and your grandmom decide to give you chocolates, right? And you and your sister decided to distribute the chocolates equally. Okay, now how would you do that, right? You discuss with your sister that whatever is the number of chocolates I'll be getting from papa, from mama and from grandmom, I'll be giving you half of them, right? Now papa, mama and grandmom. Okay, now papa has given you 10 chocolates, mama has given you 6 chocolates, grandmom has given you 8 chocolates, right? So number of chocolates you are getting and number of chocolates your sister Tina is getting. Papa has given you 10 chocolates, you will be taking 5. And Tina will be taking 5, right? So this is 5 out of 10. And this is 5 out of 10. Okay? From mama, mama has given you 6 chocolates. So you will be taking 3 out of 6. And Tina will also be taking 3 out of 6, right? Grandmom has given you 8 chocolates. You will be taking 4 out of 8. And Tina, you will give 4 out of 8, right? Now what have you decided to give half of the chocolates to Tina and half of the chocolates you will have? That means you have 5 out of 10, you have 3 out of 6, you have 4 out of 8. That means each fraction is equivalent to half. Okay, because you have decided to keep half of the chocolates and each fraction over here is also half, right? So 5 by 10 is also half, 3 by 6 is also half and 4 by 8 is also half, right? So if you have 1 by 2, it is, if 1 is divided into 5 parts, 2 will also be divided into 5 parts. So 1 into 5, 5, 2 into 5, 10. Similarly, 1 by 2, if it is divided into 3 parts, it is divided into 3 parts, so it is 3 by 6. Okay? Similarly, 1 by 2, if 1 is divided into 4 parts, 2 is divided into 4 parts, then it is 4 by 8. Okay? Now, we have this rectangle over here. It is divided into 3 equal parts, right? So, this part is 1 by 3, this is 1 by 3, and this is 1 by 3. Now, what if I divide this each of this part into 2 more parts? So, I show you. Okay, so now I have divided each part into 2 equal parts, right? Now, now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, out of 6 parts, 2 of them are green, right? Out of 6, 2 of them are green. Out of 6, 2 of them are pink. Out of 6, 2 of them are orange. Right? Now, I didn't change any portion. Right? That means 1 by 3 is equal to 2 by 6. Still, green is the same portion, pink is the same portion, and orange is the same portion. Right? I divided each portion into 2 parts. Right? So, 1 by 3, if I divide each portion into 2 parts, that means I'll be getting 2 by 6. Each portion into 2 parts, I'll be getting 2 by 6. That means 1 by 3 is equal to 2 by 6. Okay? You can see the portion is still same. Initially, we were having this entire portion as green. So, out of 3 equal portions, one was green and one was pink and one was orange. Now this green portion has been divided into 2 equal parts and this pink portion is divided into 2 equal parts and orange portion is also divided into 2 equal parts. Now we have 6 equal parts. Out of 6, 2 of them are green, 2 of them are pink and 2 of them are orange. Right? So I have divided each part, this one part into 2. One part into 2. So, 3 part into 2. So, 1 part into 2 is 2 and total 3 parts divided into 2 parts. So, there will be 6 parts. Right? You can see initially there were 3 parts. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, if 3 parts, I have this 3 parts over here. So, if 3 parts, each part is divided into 2, you'll be getting 6 parts. So, 3 parts, each part is divided into 2. So, you get 3 into 2, 6 parts. Okay? So, 1 upon 3 is equal to 2 upon 6. And further, if we divide this into equal portions, then what? So, I do one thing. I draw a vertical line over here. Okay, now you can see how many parts are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 parts are there. right? 12 parts are there. Out of 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 are green, right? So 4 by 12 is green, 4 by 12 is pink, 4 by 12 is orange. Okay, initially I was having this complete part, one part, and total it is three parts. Now this one part, this entire part is divided into four parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. So three parts will be divided into 3 into 4 parts. So total 4 parts, 3 into 4, 12, right? So 4 by 12 is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, so these are called equivalent fractions. Now here you can see this triangle. This triangle is divided into 3 equal parts, right? So it is 1 by 3. Now each part is divided into 2. Okay, so that you can see here. This part is divided into 2 part, this part into 2 part, and this part into 2 part. So both of them are looking as same. So this portion is, how many parts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts. And orange portion is 1 and 2. And here orange portion is 1 out of 3. And here orange portion is 2 out of 6. But orange portion is same in both the cases. That means 1 by 3 is equal to 2 by 6. Right? So one part is divided into 2 part. So 3 part will also be divided into 2 parts. So total 2 parts out of 6 parts, right? 2 part, 2 part, 3 into 2, 6, 1 into 2, 2. Okay? So kids, I hope you are clear with equivalent fractions. In the next lesson, we'll learn more about fractions. Do revise this session and the previous ones. I'll see you in the next session once again. Bye-bye.